call is put the data in order. Now that's going to be a little bit tricky because, so I'm going to show you guys a couple of ways we could do it. I could rearrange it. 50, I know, is going to go at the end. I'm going to put 48. Let me put 48 before 50. 40, I have another 48 here. I have another 48 here. Looks like I have a couple of 49s. Okay, let me move these 48s over. However you want to do it, you got to put this data in order. Great, data's now in order. As you can see, I have two 46s, three 48s, four 49s, and a 50. So the mode of this data is going to be 49. I'm not going to worry about mean right now. We've done enough of that. Let's talk about how to find the median. So we need to find what's in the center. Cross out the smallest, cross out the biggest. 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 Uh-oh, we got two numbers in the middle. I am going to circle those two numbers. The median is going to be in between them. What is in between 40 and 49? I know the answer is a little bit obvious here, but for those of us who have trouble with there, let me get my calculator. We are going to find the mean of these two numbers. I'm going to do 48 plus 49, which equals 97. There is two numbers there. I'm going to divide those by two. The answer is 48.5. So in this data set, the median is 48.5. That means half of my data is going to be smaller than 48.5. Half of my data is going to be larger than 48.5. This is how we find the median. Now in this problem, we see median and mode are not so far apart from each other. Tomorrow, we are going to talk about how to find, comparing the three of them, mean, median, and mode.